Good day, everyone. Tropical update time now with J7409, the name you know, the news you can use. Before I even get started this morning, is Hurricane Beryl one of the strangest looking little hurricanes you've ever seen? Maybe it's happened before, they're this small. I've only been around so many years, I'm not going to say it hasn't happened before, but there's just something strange about this storm. Anyway, up here, this, my friends, they call it disturbance number one, but it's actually 96L, okay? A well-defined low-pressure system located about midway between the southeastern United States and Bermuda, and it's producing disorganized showers and a few thunderstorms. Environmental conditions appear conducive for some gradual development during the next couple of days while the system moves slowly northwestward, then northward off the coast of North Carolina. Although the system is forecast to interact with a frontal zone early next week, first part of the week, it could linger off the southeast United States coast where some additional development is possible. 2 days, 40%, 5 days, 50%. What is saving us here, folks, is this system that's moving off, which is going to be bringing us cooler air. That's what's saving this little thing right here from coming right on up, okay? But that's not going to happen. Do not worry. This, as it looks now, should not be a threat to anyone in any shape or form. Now, let's get to Beryl. Here we go. All right, as of 5 a.m. this morning, it's still a Category 1 with winds of 75 miles per hour. Now, the minimum central pressure is 995 millibars if you're tracking it. 10.6 north, 45.1 west, and it is moving at 14 miles per hour. Now, as we take a look at the National Hurricane Center tracking map, you can still see no one on the islands are under any kind of watches or warnings at this time. It is still a hurricane. And as you can see, by tomorrow afternoon, it should still be a hurricane. But by early Sunday morning, it should be a tropical storm, knocked down to tropical storm status. And as of 2 a.m. Monday is when you guys will get what rain or wind you're going to get right up in this area. Okay? Now, some models are even forecasting it may dissipate before it gets to you. I'm not going to say it is. I'm not going to say it isn't at this point. I know what things look like, but this particular storm has just been mind-blowing to try to keep up with, and for the size of it especially, okay? I'm going to show you something in a minute, and it doesn't even look like nothing but big old rain showers when you look at some of the models, but it's just something. That's all I'm going to say. I am going to tell you though, if you are in any of the islands here, it should not be a hurricane as of now. I may come back later today and say, well, it's going to be a hurricane. This thing is unreal to try to keep track of. But as of now, from the National Hurricane Center, it should not be. It's got it down here as tropical storm status. But like I say, some models are even forecasting it may dissipate and just be a big old rain shower before it gets there. We will have to wait and see. So, on the smart side, I'm not saying safe side, it is safe side, but on the smart side, make sure you have your kits and your plans ready, okay? In case you do get some wind or some rain that happens to start flooding some areas, you would know what to do. Now, we have to go through this if you actually really want to know what's going on and not a bunch of, well, I'm thinking this, I'm thinking that from me or anybody else on YouTube. If you want to know exactly what the National Hurricane Center is saying, hold on. Here we go. The deep convection associated with a tiny tropical cyclone has continued to become better organized overnight. Okay? The earlier microwave overpass showed a well-defined mid-level eye, and also a pinhole eye has been apparent in the various GO-16 satellite channels since shortly after 0600 UTC, and was most evident around the 0017 UTC. Now, although the clarity of the eye has waxed and waned since that time, there is enough convection organization to increase the initial intensity to 65 knots, making Beryl the first hurricane of the 2018 Atlantic hurricane season. Now, the cyclone has another 18, this is important, 18 to 24 hour within very low vertical wind shear. That's important. Remember, we've been talking about the wind shear and how it was going to help tear it apart. There's also a high pressure that should kick the dickens out of it. But anyway, it's still got another 18 to 24 hours in very low vertical wind shear conditions. Okay? And the SSTS, that's just the temperature in Celsius of the ocean, 26 to 27. Now, these favorable conditions suggest that the tiny hurricane is likely to intensify further today. The National Hurricane Center intensity forecast calls for additional strengthening and is at the upper end of the intensity guidance, but I would not be too surprised if the compact hurricane reaches a slightly higher peak of intensity than is indicated below, and I'll show you what they're saying. This little storm is just unreal, folks. Now, about 36 hours, the shear is forecast to increase to more than 15 knots, and it is expected to be greater than 20 knots shortly after that. And this should cause the very small tropical cyclone to quickly weaken. However, as mentioned, there is greater uncertainty than usual regarding Beryl's intensity forecast, okay? Although the updated National Hurricane Center forecast shows Beryl reaching the Lesser Antilles as a tropical storm, it is highly possible that the system will have degenerated, remember what I told you, degenerated into an open trough by that time. Regardless of the system status at 72 hours, it is likely to bring strong gusty winds and locally heavy rains to portions of the Lesser Antilles Sunday and Monday. Now, I'm thinking late Sunday night and a lot of Monday. So that's what I'm thinking. We'll have to wait and see, okay? And this is the intensity forecast down here. They've got it up to, let's see here, in 12 hours, having 85 mile per hour winds. They said, do not be surprised if it gets a little stronger, okay? And then, of course, within 2 days' time, here we go, 65, it starts to degenerate and keeps bumping down, okay? In 96 hours, they think it will be dissipated. Now, here's a quick check of what Beryl is looking like. Is this a strange little critter or what? I keep trying to find the eye, but it's so small, I need new glasses. Maybe it's just me, people, but I cannot hardly find it at all. I'm sure right in here is where they're talking about where this gap is, but it just looks weird, doesn't it? It doesn't look like a hurricane when you expect one to. We're used to these big bad hurricanes with all the wind around them and the circulation and da-di-da. Well, this is what Beryl looks like. Here's the points right here. You can see hurricane over here, tropical storm. I'll cut that off. let you see it a little better. Let's put up the coordinates on the map right quick. Everybody can see where it is if you're tracking it. And there are no watches and warnings, okay? So this is what Hurricane Beryl's looking like. Now let's take a quick gander at the European model this morning. Here is Beryl. Now, does that look like your average hurricane when you're looking? Especially all you people who go, Vent Sky said this, or the GFS said this. It don't look like nothing you've ever seen before as a hurricane, hardly, does it? This is the European model, okay? We'll go to the GFS model. This is what it looks like on the GFS model. Just a very little tiny swirl going on in there. Pretty wild looking, huh? This is around 10 a.m. this morning, and here's the system up here off of my coast. So we'll move it up to around 2 p.m. this afternoon. 8 p.m. this evening. Looks a little bit better organized, but this is just a weird looking storm to me, people, to be a Category 1 hurricane. That's all I'm saying. Tell me what you think. All right, Sunday, this is around 2 p.m. I mean Saturday, excuse me, around 2 p.m. We'll go to Sunday. This is in the evening. And this is a European model. Let's hop over to the GFS model. It should be a tropical storm, hopefully by now. And here is my system off the coast, and it's getting right to get sucked up, thank goodness. That's what's saving us. Monday, here we go. Now, it should have passed on across, okay? I'll get in a little more depth and blow things up in a little more detail when Monday gets a little bit closer and we see exactly what's going on with this, okay? Okay, here's a quick shot of a model I really like to go by. Do not pay these any mind. Okay, it's going to be nothing. It's just where they're tracking where things, the systems may go, but this is out of nothing to worry about. This is the main system right here in the black, the one that really lets you know what's going on. As you can see, still has that little bit of split, but it's so close. This is a TVCN model, and it's got it a little close to Guadeloupe, but it's down in the island around Dominica. Anywhere from Martinique up to Guadeloupe, you see the cone right here of uncertainty. It could still go anywhere around this, but it should be a tropical storm with 50 mile per hour winds when it passes this way. So, will it be? It's up in the air, folks. I'm just being honest with you. It could be a whole lot less. It could be nothing at all except a big old rain shower, or it could be a little more. We're going to have to wait and see what happens. But I really think that the dry air and the sheer wind are going to get to it and bring it on down. And then once it gets to a certain state, that big old high pressure that's coming off that's saving us from this system up here, pushing it out, it's going to get into it and it's going to slam it big time. That's what I think, but we're going to wait and see. Everybody have a safe day, a blessed day. I'll be bringing you updates throughout today. If I see any major changes, I'll be sure and put them right up. If not, I'll wait and do a complete forecast as they come in. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe, click the bell, make sure you get all the latest in weather news, forecast, alerts, watches, and tropical weather. Thank you so much for everything you do for me. May each of you have a good day, and remember, keep your eyes on the sky and everything around you. Peace, love, and kindness to all.